Success stories don't come much better than this. A boy from the Australian bush saves a few bob, packs his guitar, and sets out for Nashville, hoping to crack America's massive country music market. For a decade, he meets rejection and battles personal demons, but he never gives up. Then, flat broke and out of luck, he's discovered and becomes the hottest country singer in all America. Sounds far-fetched? Not if you're Keith Urban. Gonna kick off my shoes and down in bare feet, where the grass and the dirt and the gravel on me. It's the middle of the night, middle America.
I don't know where the hell we're playing.
Chester, West Virginia.
But the bloke clutching the Aussie beer is pure Australian.
I said, shut up, you baloney.
Introducing the Urban Cowboy, Keith Urban. So give us some
fresh air, give me that farm. You're a born entertainer.
I'm a bit of a show-off. And there is something intrinsically wrong with that, don't you think? You're basically getting on stage and going, look at me, look at me, look at me. It's like, you've got some serious issues.
His music is a high-voltage fusion of country and rock and roll. In America today, there's none hotter.
Keith Urban!
Urban CDs sell in the millions. His tours are constantly sold out.
If the boss has any sway at all, this is the one that gets it. So the middle bunk's prime real estate.
Okay.
So there's three on there, three there, three there, and three there. So there's 12 altogether.
Okay.
And we've got, I think, 9 in our bus right now, 10 including the driver.
This is the kitchen?
Yeah, a little kitchen area, so we make coffee and microwave and pantry and stuff. Got to have that bar fully stocked up there. I must have been born a
lucky guy. Keith's love for music began as a kid. A kid from Caboolture in Queensland.
I think I was about 7. Then my dad took me to see Johnny Cash. Just watching Johnny Cash, especially on that stage with this big white spotlight and all the smoke from the people smoking cigarettes wafting up through it. And I remember just looking up thinking, I want to do that.
I want to be Johnny Cash.
Yeah, I just want to be that guy up in that spotlight.
By age 8, he was winning country music competitions. By his early 20s, he'd won Best Male Vocalist at the Tamworth Country Music Awards.
Keith Urban.
It was 1991. Keith had talent and a bad haircut. I mean, really bad.
Thank you.
But this tyro with the bottle blonde mullet also had a dream: to conquer America. I left the office in a flash on Friday,
threw my boots in the car, cashed my paycheck. This ugly little establishment down here is called 12th and Porter. And I don't know how long it's been there, but we played our very first shows in here.
Oh, really?
And it's still pretty much, you can go and see live entertainment every night in that little hole of a place, and it's packed.
When you came to Nashville, what were you expecting?
That's an excellent question. I don't think I really had any ideas of what Nashville was going to be like. I thought it would be like a really small little town that was pretty easy to get around in and just, you know.
And what were you expecting for yourself?
A little quicker acceptance. That didn't happen. I can see that old man, he's
walking past our door. If Keith came expecting instant fame, what he found was hard slog and rejection. Year after lonely year of it.
It was frustrating, and I guess I kept thinking, boy, I didn't think it was going to be this hard, but it never occurred to me to stop.
How hard did it get?
Well, my manager, Greg, and my drummer, Peter Clark, who also came across from Australia, they took to mowing lawns for income. I was writing songs during the day, living off this pathetic little publishing advance, and they were both going out and cutting grass. And the iron, the beautiful thing about cutting grass is that, as like cutting records, is that when people would call from Australia and say, how are you guys doing? And we go, well, we're actually, you were cutting this week. We had one show where there was three people. It was a place called the Dingo Bar in Albuquerque. Should have known. They booked us into this club and we started playing, and there was four people in the club. One of them was the bartender, and we played a song, and one of the guys at the bar left. I went, okay, this is not good. And so I said, let's ditch the set and do like a cover song. And when we finished it, that other guy left. So we're down to the bartender and our record company exec, and I said, we better stop. So we just quit.
How do you get out of, you know, that mindset? I imagine you just dread the next place thinking.
You just drink. That's all we did.
It wasn't just drink Keith turned to. Loneliness and failure saw him seek solace in drugs. At his lowest, Urban was on a constant cocaine high.
Wasn't in good shape, and I was just lost and confused. I knew I had to be here, but it was so difficult. I had no idea what I was doing, but just kind of, you know, just wandered around aimlessly for a while.
Did you fall into the trap of drugs?
Yeah, I found a deviation in those. And I felt like I could, you know, it's a typical addict syndrome. I can do this alone. I don't need anybody, you know.
Did you class yourself as an addict?
At the time, I did. I think in hindsight, I have a tendency to get depressed to the point where I find solace in less than healthy things.
How did you get out of that?
Some little voice kept saying to me, you didn't come here to do this. You know, you didn't come here to do this and be this. It's just, this is not you. Some voice kept saying to me, this is not you.
Keith conquered his demons, cleaned up his act, and began to get noticed.
I love you, Keith!
His records got airplay. His concerts sold out. His name became known.
We're gonna do in a couple seconds, we're gonna bring Keith in, we're gonna put him right here, we're gonna do our meet and greet. However, one autograph item per person.
After 10 years of hard labor, Keith Urban was discovered. I'm alive and I'm free.
He's a star. He's a star. First, second, third, fourth, fifth. And then you discover that he is a great guitar player and he has all these other elements, but he's really a star in every way you can define it.
Mike Dungan is the powerful head of Capitol Records, a man with his finger on both the vertical and horizontal pulse of country music, whatever that means.
In my 23-year career, I've never worked with anyone who has as much vertical and horizontal potential as Keith does. I really think his potential is just enormous.
And if there's one thing that you can say is the defining quality of Keith, what is that?
It's the intangible that makes the difference. It's that drop-dead, walk-in-a-room star power that so few have, and Keith has it.
God, I remember that. I knew it was in the memory bank somewhere.
Such a pretty little thing, I want a booty wedding ring on your finger.
You write a lot about relationships.
Yeah.
Are you good at that?
I'm still single, so evidently not. You know, I don't know if it's that I'm not good at it or whatever. I just haven't found that what I'm looking for yet.
When he strikes out, he will strikes out.
Ah, so close.
Beer and bowling, that pastime of the single guy, is Urban's preferred way of winding down.
I brought this ball all the way from Australia. Better?
I don't know what I'm best at. I like playing and I like singing and I like writing songs and I try to get better at all of them. And I try to be a good entertainer too.
But guitar work is something you're really well known for. I mean, your guitar work is considered fantastic.
Well, that's why my mum's my publicist.
Keith remains proudly Australian. But ironically, Australians are still a little unsure who he is.
How long before they're going to be ready, do you think?
It is an interesting situation when you can have this very Australian man who is probably better known here than he is in his own home.
Well, can I say, maybe you blew it.
I'd like to get to the point where I can tour when I want to tour and not when you have to. That's it, not when you have to.
So are you making money?
Not yet, but I'm getting close. There's a big hole to fill in, let's put it that way. 10 years creates a big hole.
You must be getting close.
It's a big hole.
Keith Urban is proof that perseverance pays off. He's copped the knockbacks. Now the rewards. Shining down on me and you.
When you put your arms around me. What's the best feeling?
Going to a town you've never been to before and seeing people sing songs that you wrote in your bedroom or in your shower. That's a really freaky feeling. I've never met these people. James Taylor's got a song about that. And he says, fortune and fame, such a curious game. Perfect strangers call you by name. Pay good money to hear fire and rain again and again and again. It's perfect. It totally sums it up.
Hello, I'm Liz Hayes. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9 Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.